suppose I chose acrylics because they can do a lot of things. They're a very versatile medium. I guess that drew me, and also the quick drying time. I don't like having to wait for results, so that was a definite draw. But the versatility and being able to use multiple mediums to create different effects was definitely something that drew me into it. So you can create different textures, different levels of interest, different levels of...
So can you build different layers up?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, you can do washes, you can do... you can create washes, you can create work in layers, you can work in textural impasto paint to create heavy body in the works, and you can work with very fluid paint and create, almost capture the movement. So it's a very versatile medium, and I'm very drawn to that. I'm drawn to very bright colours in a lot of my works, though I can do subdued, more realistic works as well. I think the draw to the more vibrant, and at the moment very fluorescent colouring, is sort of the dichotomy of how attracting they are to the eye, but the history behind why that instinctual attractiveness is there. How it is actually a warning system, but we're still drawn to the colours, that it is so popular in fashion, it's so popular in advertising, and it's just interesting to delve into that history behind why we are drawn to that. Well, I guess I got introduced to painting relatively young. My grandmother was a painter and a drawer, and she was very artsy, very involved in the arts, and she moved around a lot, so I didn't spend a lot of time with her. So it was something we could do together that was sort of just between us. So we spent a lot of time sort of in her space, sort of just together, creating works, and it was a bonding time that we got to spend together, because she'd be there for a few years at a time, and then she'd decide to take off, and she'd spend time, 5 years over in America, 5 years over in England, and then she'd come back and visit. So it was very sporadic, the time that we got to spend together. So she was definitely an influence that got me started. In saying that, I was always drawing on things. Like, I can remember a story my mum told me. She had this pristine white statue, sort of influenced from the Greek era. And I obviously thought it wasn't colourful enough, so I took the paints that I had at the time and decided to, I guess, deface that statue. So it's stories like that, or like in our old house, the bricks and the speckled effect that they had, and taking a pen and creating images from those dots. Always stories like that growing up, and I guess that's why my parents decided when I was about 8 they were going to send me to workshops, and so throughout all of the school holidays I was always at art workshops, like for ceramics, for printing, for weaving, for printmaking, for card making. It was a wide variety, sort of engulfed in every medium possible. And then last year of primary school, I can remember we had an artist in residence come and join us, and he was going over the very basics of drawing, just with graphite pencils and erasers, and that was all we used in the classes that he was taught. And I can remember always being sort of pulled aside and being pushed more than the other students. And in the end, he actually ended up giving me free, I I think it was three free lessons to his studio space that I ended up doing in that transition period moving to high school. So I guess that was the start of really pushing my art further than just something I enjoyed. Definitely did art all throughout high school. It was one of those constant subjects that was a relief from religion and English and math. And it was one of those subjects that, even though there was work involved, it was something that was a release. It was something you could delve into and really creatively explore and just move further in depth with. And I mean, it wasn't just one medium either. It was acrylics, it was sculpture, it was photography, it was a whole body of mediums that sort of influenced where I ended up going. Saying that, I did get quite ill when I was about 14 years old, and that definitely had an impact, because at the end of high school I ended up basically hiding from the world. And so for 4 years I barely interacted with my family, let alone the outside world. And emerging from that hibernation, I guess you could call it, I basically was looking for a gentle way to enter into the workplace, I guess. And the easiest way to do that was through like business administration. It was through like getting your RSA and doing front of house. Those were the most prolific jobs where I was living in Bundaberg. So that definitely influenced where I was going. And from there, I did finance, as I was quite skilled with sort of like your math and very applicable math rather than the more egocentric sort of math that answers questions that don't necessarily have an applicable reason. But it was during doing the Cert 4 for finance that one day, as I was struggling with these few units that I had left, that my mum comes home and she says, "Are you aware that they now have visual arts units and classes available in Bundaberg?" And I was just like, "You really shouldn't have told me that." And from that point on, it was sort of like I moved my focus and I went and put my portfolio in and started my Cert 4. And I never finished those last few units of that finance degree. And so I completed my Cert 4, went on to do my diploma. And I mostly focused on drawing and acrylics, just because in the setting it was in, you were very mobile. And so you needed mediums that you could move places very easily and not something that you needed a set studio to work in. And those were the mediums that you could sort of transport very easily. And you needed works that dried quite quickly as well, because in transporting works, that was very important. In saying that, by the end of the diploma, I was offered a position to go and do my bachelor's. And that's what I'm now currently completing. I guess I sort of fell into the use of palette knives just in the last 2 years. It's sort of wanting to get more texture into my paint, sort of wanting to deepen the layers and deepen how you can work up the elements of certain areas in the paint. And it's a different, a very different mark left by a palette knife than it is with a brush. And I do very enjoy the marks that are left by the tools as you paint. I think that sort of distinguishes your work from a photograph. It's what sort of gives it a very human element to the works. And that's something I've definitely been exploring in my bachelor's as I've sort of developed the skills with my palette knives. Because I really only, like as I'm finishing my bachelor's now, sort of the skills have only just sort of emerged where I'm happy with the marks I'm making as I've learned how to sort of play with the knife and the angles to use and how what marks are left with however you hold the knife. I guess a good example of my use of palette knives would be like these works here. They were created as one of my creative projects for my diploma, my bachelor's. And sort of with the idea of creating a body of work, celebrating the almost eradication of polio. But using the fluoro colors actually brought a lot of different connotations into the project, especially because like a lot of the natural occurrences of that pigmentation is sort of like in poisonous frogs. It's sort of that warning system to let you know of danger, of like this animal is poisonous, this plant is poisonous. It's that sort of bright, sort of electric warning system that's very instinctual in the person. So it brought a lot of different uneasy sort of feelings to the project that weren't originally a part of the idea, but as this project developed, they actually had polio epidemics break out in a couple of countries where polio had almost been eradicated for 5 years. So it sort of brought that element of how keeping up the aftercare is so important. And so it was sort of that new element on the project. And when you look at sort of the techniques and the palette knife, it's very textural, working on wet to working on dry, you get very different effects, and different textured paint also creates different interactions together. Like you can have a very sort of like impasto, very sort of pasty paint to something that's very liquefied, very silky, and how they interact is quite interesting. Like you can see just up the top here in the background how the paint is sort of interacting. It's those two different elements gives you sort of just those little hints of the darker pasty color coming through with that more silky color sort of dominating the paint. And it's interesting how when you think that the pasty paint would actually dominate the paint color, it actually gets wiped away. And so I do tend to use a lot of impasto paints to just get that textural sort of definition into the works. So like, probably see best just in the eyes a lot of the time is where I want to sort of bring that definition and bring that light and bring that depth. Because that's where your interest should be captured the most. And so getting that textural element, and especially working like with the palette knife and trying to get round circles was very interesting. And so this project really sort of built my skill, because I mean, you're working within like a 10-week period to create 8 works. And that's from the sketching, that's from building your project in your mind, to developing the images, it's to getting them on canvas and then painting them. And that's along with other assessments, and it was a very big struggle to actually get it done in that time frame. So it was quite accomplished having completed them to the standard that they were at. And yeah, you stare at them long enough and there's always nitpicky things, and you get to the end and you always hate the body of work. But you get to a point where you just have to learn to step back, leave them alone for like a month, and then come back to them anew and you actually have a new interaction with the project altogether. And it shows into the development of my new work, whereas realizing that I do quite a lot of figurative in my work and a lot of portraits, it's sort of moving away from that and working into landscapes. And so I was working on this new body of work for my final project of my bachelor's, and it was working on just plain landscapes, no figures at all. And I wanted to keep it relatively abstract. I was working in the landscape, but with the idea that I was actually going to hang them all on the wall portrait. As the project developed, it took on a life of its own. It was very much an organic process, which isn't usually how I work. I usually work from photographs and have a very set idea of how the canvas will be sort of realized in the end. And this was sort of a different twist on that, sort of pushing myself to not have the final product in my mind. And so I had no idea what colors I was using when I started the canvases. I had no idea how it was going to be presented. And so it was a very organic sort of stripping my control over the product, over the canvas. And so it was very much sort of stepping out of the comfort zone. And so with this one, it was sort of, it definitely pushed my palette knife skills, but it was more building on color theory. It was pushing into that instinctive use of why we choose different colors. And also sort of letting the project develop organically and naturally, and sort of where the project, as you research through, is going to take itself. And it was very interesting that in the end, it actually became more sculptural in itself, and that it was seeing them individually, they didn't actually relate as the triptych, which was the original intent. So I actually had to go back in and rework two of the canvases quite a bit to actually make them work as a cohesive body. And once that happened, putting them together into that sculptural element sort of lifted it to a new plane. And that actually was a very interesting concept that I'm going to want to explore further, and actually have plans in my head already for a whole new series of work. And in that project, I actually explored a new medium in fluid paint. And it was very sort of dynamic in how you use it. But it was very instinctual. Yes, I watched YouTube videos. Yes, I talked to a fellow artist who bases her practice around this medium. But I did one test piece, realized that it wasn't level and that it was quite ruined. And then just went straight in on canvas. And it was quite sort of liberating to free all control and just let the paint do what it does naturally. And so it's a new element into my work that I'm looking forward to